My role on this project is environmental manager. So I work with a team of people. We have ecologists, whether it's aquatic ecologists, terrestrials, depending on the area of work we're doing. The fulfilling part of the role is seeing the likes of the wetland planting and some of these more sort of, I guess, beneficial long-term scenarios where we're actually benefiting the surrounding environment rather than disturbing it temporarily. So it's quite a rewarding part of the role. And in terms of creation of the wetlands, it is quite a process. So obviously before we can even get into and start constructing these wetlands, we have to do a whole lot of preparation work. This often the soils completely change. We might be digging out existing soils to then create the new basins, which have to have the right level of topsoil and things all laid throughout. Then you get into your plants and things. So this one behind me here, this was kind of a very, very different environment beforehand. We had the sand dunes coming through, so a whole lot of that work has to happen before we can even carve out this basin here before we can get to the planting stage. So this one's quite far along in the process, but we've still got a long way to go with a lot of our other wetlands. With us still at the moment essentially just runoff basins for our sediment control on site. So in terms of challenges so far with the success of our planting, we're still very much in the construction phase of the project. So it hasn't been too challenging to date because we've got the likes of our landscape team coming through and maintaining the plants as we go, and we're all here on site. As we move forward, yeah, it can become a bit more challenging in terms of making sure that we don't have invasive weeds coming through, but we'll still have people monitoring that going forward to make sure that, you know, that it is successful longer term. We've still got a wee way to go in the construction phase at the moment, just working through the program and things, but in terms of the completion of the wetlands, like I said, depending on that completion date of construction, it's sort of at least 5 years in terms of really ticking off as being successful. Even then, once we hand over, because we're obviously the contractor constructing the wetlands and so on, once we hand over to NZTA, then obviously these areas need to be maintained in perpetuity, so long, you know, forever. So that'll transfer into their responsibility. So there'll always be people keeping an eye on it. And there's also that responsibility from the regional and district councils to make sure that these areas are maintained, so that the local community know that they've got something special to be proud of.
On the bottom of the wetlands, there is little ponds that they've made. So the bottom's not flat, the bottom's designed to catch all the silts, so it sort of undulates. The deepest, shallowest ends are in the north end, and the deepest ends in the south, because that's the widest end.
In terms of monitoring post-construction, we have a whole range of different monitoring regions that we have to do. One being wetlands, the other is sort of our local water, surface water bodies, so streams and rivers. We also have a lot of riparian planting that we do off-site, so outside the project footprint, that has to be monitored. So like I said, it's sort of a 5-year time frame unless we can demonstrate success prior to that. But yeah, essentially around 5 years of monitoring that goes into looking at things like canopy cover, diversity of species and plants and things, whether there's, weeds are coming through and invading the wetland areas, particularly from the surrounding areas, which might be a bit drier, and when you get weeds and things encroaching into our nice new planting, it's quite a challenge going forward.